my dear students, welcome to mathematics class. In this video we are going to discuss about compound angles, subject to task 2. Are you ready to watch? Then let's begin our first problem. So coming to the question number 1, show that cos 42 degrees plus cos 78 degrees plus cos 162 degrees is equals to 0. Okay, so actually my dear, here we don't know any one of the value. To be frank, directly we don't know about cos 42 degrees, even cos 78 degrees, even about cos 162 degrees also, we don't know directly because these are not standard angles. But even though, using the compound angle concepts, we can solve this very easily. So see here, so cos 42 degrees, see 42 degrees, let us write it as a, write it as 60 degrees minus 18 degrees plus cos 78 is nothing but 60 plus 18 degrees, isn't it? See, first one is 60 minus 18, second one is 60 plus 18, and this is better, you can write it as 180 minus 18 degrees. Okay ma, so this is what, something plus 18, something minus 18, that is the concept here. So let it be the LHS. Now just you can expand cos of A minus B. What is the formula for cos of A minus B? Cos A into cos B, that is cos 60 degrees into cos 18 degrees plus sin A into sin B, isn't it? In the same manner, now here can apply cos of A plus B. So that is cos A into cos B minus sin A into sin B. Okay ma, plus coming to the last one, it is like 180 minus theta. So because of 180, cos remains as cos itself. And you know 180 minus theta, which is second quadrant, hence cos is negative. Hence the value of entire this is nothing but minus cos 18 degrees. Okay, fine. Now let us substitute the values. Cos 60 degrees is nothing but 1 by 2 into cos 18 degrees. Right now we don't know what is cos 18 degrees. And coming to this is sin 60 is equals to root 3 by 2 into sin 18 degrees plus, what about this is once again 1 by 2 into cos 18 degrees minus root 3 by 2 into sin 18 degrees and minus cos 18 degrees, right? So see these two terms, one is positive, one is negative, hence they cancel. And you see my dear, this is half cos 18 degrees plus half cos 18 degrees. So if you take cos 18 degrees common here, half plus half, which is nothing but 1. So 1 into cos 18 degrees, which is cos 18 degrees. And there is a last one more term, that is minus cos 18 degrees. So plus cos 18 degrees, minus cos 18 degrees gets cancelled. Hence answer is 0. So which is the right hand side. So dear, please observe this. This type of knowledge we need to get it. So the first step itself, very very important step here. So 42 we can write it as 60 minus 18. 78 we can write it as 60 plus 18. And at last 162 we can write it as 180 minus 18 degrees.
right? Next question. Find the expansion of sine of a plus b minus c. You know, method number one, actually we already discussed about the formula of sine of a plus b plus c. In the formula, you need to replace just minus c in the place of plus c. Okay, ma? So that is what you need to replace minus c in the place of c within the formula so that directly you can get it. Sometimes, okay, we may not be good at formula. We might have forgot the formula. Then what to do? Even though no problem. Even though no problem. See here. Sine of A plus B minus C. Isn't it? So this is, I just want to write it as sine of. You can consider combination of any two. I want to consider like this. And minus C. Just take any two together. Okay, ma. Now, you know, this is just like sine of something minus something, which is nothing but in the form of sine of a minus b. Do you understand? Now it's not a plus b minus c. It is just like something. This is everything is say some capital A, and this is say some capital B, and this is in the form of sine of a minus b. What is the formula of sine of a minus b? Sine a means a plus b, into cos b, b means c, sin a cos b minus cos a into sin b. Do you understand? This is the step number one. Now step number two, you can write again expansion of sin of a plus b. What is sin of a plus b? Sin a into cos b plus cos A into sin B, and you know this whole multiplied by cos C minus, can expand cos of A plus B, cos A into cos B minus sin A into sin B. Okay, so this whole multiplied by sin C into sin C. That entirely should be multiplied by sin C. Yes, just simply you can multiply now with cos C. So this is nothing but then sin A into cos B into cos C plus cos A into sin B into cos C. And this time we need to multiply with sin C now. So minus cos A into cos B into sin C, and minus of minus plus sin A into sin B into sin C. So this is the expansion of sin of A plus B minus C. So whenever three or more angles are given to you, if you are good at formula, then you can substitute directly. If not, take any two angles together so that now it will be converted into the form of A plus B or A minus B. Okay. So look at this question now. Most important model. If capital A lies between 270 degrees to 360 degrees and capital B lies between 90 degrees to 180 degrees. Moreover, cos A is equals to 5 by 13 and tan B is equals to minus 15 by 8. Okay. Then find the values of sin of a plus b and cos of a plus b, and also we need to find the quadrant in which a plus b lies. Most important model, my dear. Okay.
So, listen here. Coming to solution, what is given for us? Cos A is given as 5 by 13. Isn't it? I mean, cos A can go with a right angle triangle. So, suppose this is 90 and if it is theta, isn't it? Oh, sorry, capital A, no? Angle is here, A. Angle A. Fine. See, cos is nothing but adjacent by hypotenuse. So, adjacent to A is 5 units. Actually, we need to take 5k. But no problem. Finally, you are going to get 5 only. And this is hypotenuse is 13k. Nothing to worry. Can consider as 13. Okay, ma. Now, can you guess what is opposite one? So, opposite one is nothing but 12. Okay. And also, my dear, you see that capital A belongs to which quadrant? That is also important. See, given that which is 270 to 360. I mean, more than 270 and less than 360. Less than 360. I think, is it fourth quadrant or not? A is belongs to fourth quadrant. That's why in fourth quadrant cos is positive. That's why provided as 5 by 13. Okay. Then let us write what about sin A here. Sin A. So what is sin A actually? Opposite by hypotenuse. 12 by 13. But my dear, since A belongs to fourth quadrant, no? So sin is negative. We must consider as negative here. Minus 12 by 13. Okay. And also, what is also given for us? Something given. Tan B. Tan B is given as minus 15 by 8. Right? And also, capital B belongs to, see, what is this is? B is lies between 90 to 180. More than 90, less than 180. I think second quadrant, isn't it? So, B belongs to Q2. That's why in second quadrant tan is negative. So that's why provided minus 15 by 8. So once again, with the help of a right angle triangle, assume it this is an angle B. Okay. Tan is nothing but opposite by adjacent. 15 by 8. Okay. Then just using the Pythagoras theorem, 15 whole square is nothing but 225. Plus 8 whole square is nothing but 64. So finally this is 289. So square root of 289, nothing but 70. Of course here it is 90 degrees. Now from this tan B, I want sin B value. What is sin B? Is nothing but opposite by hypotenuse, which is 15 by 17. Okay, ma. And the cos B value is nothing but 8 by 17. But since B belongs to second quadrant, in second quadrant sine and cosecant are positive. So rest of them negative. Hence, this is cos B value is minus 8 by 17. Do you understand, ma? See, once again, first we need to decide capital A and capital A or belongs to which quadrants. Okay. Since if you know any one of the trigonometric ratio, then with the help of a right angle triangle, we can find out the rest of the side, maybe hypotenuse, maybe opposite side, or maybe sometimes adjacent side. Okay. So we can find out the three sides of a right angle triangle. Hence, we can write any ratio, sine, cos, tan, cot, etc., etc. But we don't know whether that particular trigonometric functions are maybe positive or maybe negative. So that is why first decide that A belongs to which quadrant and B belongs to which quadrant. Then according to that, you can take positive and negative. Right, ma? Right. Now finally, A belongs to fourth quadrant and B belongs to second quadrant. So first, I want to find sine of A plus B. So what is the formula for sine of A plus B? Sine of A plus B is nothing but sine A into cos B plus cos A into sin B. Okay, ma. So sin A value is ready. Minus 12 by 13 into cos B. Cos B value is minus 8 by 17 plus cos A value is 5 by 13 and sin B value is 15 by 17. So clearly the denominators are 13 into 17 and 13 into 17. Hence what is the LCM here? LCM, we can take it as the denominator is 13 into 17. As these things can be added, no, directly minus into minus plus, and 12 into 8, 96, and plus 5 into 15, 75. So 171 by 13 into 17. So nothing is getting cancelled here. Finally 171 by 13 into 17, which is equals to 221. So this is sine of A plus B value. Sine of A plus B value, what we got it? 171 by 221. Okay. Now we need to simplify cos of A plus B. So now coming to cos of A plus B, first write the formula. Cos A into cos B minus sin A into sin B. Now replace the values of cos A value. What is cos A value is 5 by 13, no? Which is 5 by 13 already given to you. And cos B, we got it as minus 8 by 17 minus sin A value, which is minus 12 by 13, and sin B value 15 by 17. So once again, denominators are 13 into 17. 13 into 17, which is 221. And now numerators, if you multiply directly, 5 into minus 8, which is minus 40, minus into minus plus, 12 into 15, which is 180. Now 180 minus 40, what it is? 140 by 221. Right, ma? So this is the value of cos of A plus B. And what we got earlier, sin of A plus B? 171 by 221. You see, sin of A plus B is positive and cos of A plus B is also positive. So where sin and cos are positive? Are they positive in second quadrant? No, in second quadrant sin only positive but cos negative. Coming to third quadrant, sin is negative, cos also negative. But here we got both are positive. I mean, A plus B does not belongs to third quadrant also. But coming to fourth quadrant, if it is fourth quadrant, then cos positive but sin must be negative. But here sin also positive. Hence, you know, my dear, both sin and cos are positive only in first quadrant. Hence, therefore, we can say that A plus B belongs to first quadrant. This is also asked, no? A plus B lies in which quadrant? Yeah, since sin of A plus B is positive and cos of A plus B is positive, hence A plus B belongs to first quadrant. For example, sin positive, but if we get, suppose here minus 140, that means sin positive, cos negative. You know where it is possible? Sin positive and cos negative is in second quadrant. Hence, in that case, then A plus B lies in second quadrant. Right? Is it clear to you? Coming to the next question. This is also most important model, my dear. So, if A plus B is equals to 45 degrees, then prove that 1 plus tan A
into 1 plus tan b, which is equals to 2. Hence, deduce that tan 22.5 is equals to root 2 minus 1. So, let us see most important model. So, what is given here? A plus b is equals to 45 degrees. Right, ma'am? Since the condition what we need to prove is in terms of tan, then apply tan ratio on both sides. Apply tan ratio on both sides. So then this is tan of A plus B, which is equals to tan 45 degrees. Fine. Write the formula for tan of A plus B. Tan A plus tan B by 1 minus tan A into tan B, which is equals to, do you know tan 45 value is 1? Tan 45 degrees value is 1. Now in the next step, just go for cross multiplication. So this is tan A plus tan B, which is equals to 1 minus tan A into tan B. Okay. So coming to the next step, see here tan A plus tan B, and bring this term this side, minus tan A into tan B is nothing but plus tan A into tan B, which is equals to 1. Okay. And this is the next step, is very very important. Next step is nothing but add 1 on both sides. So plus 1 here I am added, even here also I want to add. So add 1 on both sides. Right, ma? Okay. Let us see the magic now. 1 plus tan A plus, in these two, I want to take tan B common. If I take tan B common, then is this 1 plus tan A, which is equals to 2. And I just want to keep a bracket here. Now see, in these two terms, I can take 1 plus tan A common. So from this, if I take 1 plus tan A common, then here 1 plus tan B, 1 plus tan B, which is equals to 2. The condition what we need to prove is clear. Okay, ma. The condition what we need to prove is clear. Now, we need to find this value, you know. We need to find tan 22.5 degrees. Let us say capital A is equals to B. Let A is equals to B. Then definitely both are equals to 22.5 degrees. Why? Because A plus B is equals to 45 degrees, no? Then when A and B are equal, hence both must be 22.5 plus 22.5 together, which is 45.5. Now the same thing you can apply here. That is, I can say this is 1 plus tan A into 1 plus tan, once again A, which is equals to 2. Is it not? A is equals to B. So both I want to write it in only one variable, that is capital A. 1 plus tan A into 1 plus tan A, which is 1 plus tan A entirely whole square, is equals to 2. And from this, 1 plus tan A is equals to, if you take out this square, I mean it becomes now square root. And from this, tan A is equals to root 2 minus 1. And you know, my dear, what we considered A as tan 22.5, isn't it? So therefore, tan 22.5 degrees is equals to root 2 minus 1. Hence prove. So very simple. See, step number 1. Given A plus B is equals to 45 degrees. Since the condition what we need to prove is in terms of tan, hence apply tan on both sides. Then finally we got one condition here, which is not the required one. To get that one, add 1 on both sides and then just take common tan B from this. We got 1 plus tan A
And already before that there is 1 plus tan A term. Now 1 plus tan A and 1 plus tan A, isn't it? So it is common in both. Let us take it 1 plus tan A common. After taking this is common, there is left over only 1. 1 plus tan B. So first condition is clear. Now to prove that 22.5 degrees, because their sum is 45 degrees, hence one must be 22.5 and another one also must be 22.5. And the next to prove this is, the condition is nothing but A and B both are equals to 22.5 degrees. So look at this question carefully. So earlier also we solved all actually this model, but there provided only single angle. I mean sin A is given, maybe cos B is given, I think so, in the previous one. But now coming to here, not the angles. Here the angles are compound angles. See, sin of A plus B is given something. Cos of A minus B is given something, 12 by 13. And moreover, my dear, see this condition. 0 less than A less than B less than pi by 4. You know the meaning is A and B are lies between 0 to 45 degrees. 0 to 45 degrees. I mean both A and B are less than 45. A and less B are together they are less than 45. That means A plus B is also less than 90. Isn't it, my dear? A is less than B and B is less than 45. If B itself less than 45, then A will be still less than 45 only. Isn't it? Less than B. If for example B is 30, then A can be less than the 30. Then A plus B, suppose if it is 15, then 30 plus 15, 45 only. I mean, A plus B is in first quadrant and A minus B is also first quadrant. This is what you need to observe, because I told you already the particular angle belongs to which quadrant, that is important. So first please mention that here A plus B comma A minus B are acute angles. I mean they both are belongs to first quadrant. Do you understand, ma? So because A is less than B and B is less than 45, B itself less than 45, hardly B can be 44. B can be 44 here, maximum value. And A can be 43, maximum value of A. Still less than 43 also applicable. If it is 43, if it is 44, then their addition is less than 90. Obviously in first quadrant. And no doubt their subtraction is also very minute, no? So finally, this is what you need to discuss. First of all, A plus B comma A minus B both belongs to first quadrant. That's why you see sine provided positive, cos of A minus B is also provided positive. Okay, now see what is given, ma? What is given? Sine of A plus B is given as, sine of A plus B is given as 7 by 25. Okay, so now we know the formula for cos theta is equals to under root of 1 minus sin square theta, isn't it? Cos theta is equal to, hence cos of A plus B, in the same manner if I want cos of A plus B, which is nothing but 1 minus sin square of A plus B. So 1 minus sin square of A plus B. Sin of A plus B is this. Square of this is nothing but 49 by 625. Hence which is equals to root of 625 minus 49 whole divided by 625. I think which is equals to 24 by 25. 576 you are going to get.
24 by 25.
Okay, so finally sin of A plus B is 7 by 25 and cos of A plus B is nothing but 24 by 25. Then I want tan of A plus B, ma. Tan of A plus B, tan of a plus b is nothing but sin of a plus b by cos of a plus b, right? So this is 7 by 25 by 24 by 25. 25, 25 gets cancelled, and which is equals to 7 by 24. Similarly, cos of a minus b is given as 12 by 13. Then can you tell me sin of a minus b, which is equals to root of 1 minus cos square of a minus b, isn't it? 1 minus root of 1 minus cos square of a minus b. So what is this on simplification? Root of 1 minus cos of a minus b 12 by 13, hence it's a square 144 by 169. How much? So which is equals to 169 minus 144 by 169. I think 25 by means which is equals to 5 by 13. 5 by 13. Then can you tell me tan of a minus b? Tan of a minus b is nothing but sine of a minus b, I mean 5 by 13 by cos of a minus b, which is 12 by 13. So 13, 13 cancel, hence this value is equals to 5 by 12 tan of a minus b. But you know, my dear, we need to find the tan 2a value. Let us think, how can we find tan 2a? So I just want to write once again, what we got, tan of a plus b is 7 by 24 and tan of a minus b is 5 by 12. But my dear, we need to find tan 2a value, isn't it? First time we are talking about 2a. See this technique, this is the magic. Tan 2a, I just want to write like this, a plus b plus a minus b. 2a, I just want to write it as a plus b plus a minus b. See, clearly plus b and minus b gets cancelled. A plus a, which is nothing but 2a only. But in other side, if you see, this is just like tan something plus something. I mean tan a plus tan of a plus b. Are you following? This is just like tan of a plus b. This is everything is a and this is everything is b. Now what is the formula for tan of a plus b? Tan a, I mean a means here a plus b, plus tan b, b means tan of a minus b, divided by 1 plus tan a, which is a plus b, into tan b, which is a minus b. Do you understand, ma? So this is the technique. 2a, I want to write it as a plus b plus a minus b. Okay. Now, this is just like tan of something plus something. That is tan of a plus b. Tan of alpha plus beta. So using the compound angle formula of tan of a plus b. Tan a plus tan b by 1 minus tan a tan b. Okay. Fine. Now already we know tan of a plus b and tan of a minus b. No? Just replace the values. This is 7 by 24 plus 5 by 12 by 1 minus 7 by 24 into 5 by 12. So after substituting the values, go for LCM. 24 and 12, LCM is 24, hence this is 24 in this 24 one time, 1 into 7, 7, plus here the denominator is 12, 12 in this 24 2 times, 2 into 5, 10. So 7 plus 10 divided by 24, and coming to the down part, denominator part, here the LCM is nothing but product of 24 and 12, 24 into 12, which is 288, So 288, if you can go for cross multiplication, 288 into 1, 288 minus 35 by 288. So this part is nothing but 17 by 24. Okay, whole divided by, when this comes to numerator, we take reciprocal, no? 288 by, the difference of these two is nothing but 253. Now 24 in this 288, 1 time 24, remainder will be 4, 48 means 2 times. Hence this is 17 into 12 by 253. Therefore, tan 2a value is equals to 17 into 12, if you simplify, we get 204. So 204 by 253 is the answer. Okay, ma.
I think you may get one doubt that why these are positive, why nothing is negative. So clearly, given that A is less than B is less than pi by 4. I mean, A belongs to first quadrant, B belongs to first quadrant, even A plus B belongs to first quadrant, and even A minus B is also belongs to first quadrant. So since A plus B and A minus B belongs to first quadrant, and we know well that every trigonometric function is positive in first quadrant, so that is why all the things I considered as positive. Right? Hope you all understood the today's class, and especially various models we discussed here, and with the help of these problems, you can complete the task 2 problems. Okay, my dear. Thank you. Thank you for watching this video.